Hey folks, this is Best in the Slot, and in tonight's video, we are going to go on a tour of the Odessa Rand. This is our African zoo with many animals from across Africa, a rather elaborate kind of expansive build, which we're ending a little bit earlier than planned so we can focus on new projects in Planet Zoo. It was a little bit too big for its own britches, shall we say, but I've gone through, I've tidied things up in certain places, and what we're going to do tonight is just have a little tour. So we're going to walk around initially as a guest, as a human being, which will be a treat for me, being I am a sentient ball of light, and then we'll do like a quick overview from above as well. So let's get started. My name is Rudiger. Rudiger is here to have a day at the zoo. Now, we had many themes for the Odessa Rand, which means, by the way, the edge of the world's end, or the world's edge in Afrikaans, and that was kind of a theme that you'll see pop up now and again. Also, a theme was circles. So there's the roof from our initial dome. And the idea is this is where you'd enter the park. Now, this actually links in, if we just nip down here, this actually rotates around there. So it doesn't actually leave and enter. But the idea is if you hopped onto the tram, you would enter the park through here. And also, there's a way out of the park at the far end on the same loop. So people would kind of go around in a circle. But if you didn't know that, it would look like they were entering and leaving. And this is just a little welcome area. We have leaving times. We're going to London and Paris and Kazakhstan, and none of that makes any sense, but that's okay. It's cool anyway. So, zoo entrance. So this is the main foyer. This is the first thing we ever really built. Another reason I have to try a new zoo is this one lags constantly. Absolutely constantly. Zoo entrance over there on the right, but there we go. Just a nice little water feature kind of thing. I like the open air going on there and the leaves falling through the sky. It's all very romantic. Stop lagging, you nerd. So over here we have the south and the north. So this is one of the big themes for the zoo. It was this divide between the south of Africa and the north of Africa. Now a lot of these animals would cross over and would be present in both sides, but I kind of went with their thematically where I thought they fit the best. And the south was more sort of arid and dry, and the north was sort of more tropical and moist. That didn't necessarily make sense, but that's kind of what we rolled with. Not only did we have a list of animals, we didn't get all of these in, as I say, but we had characters resembling the north and the south. These two soldiers of African lore, based around these wire sculptures my mum brought back from Africa many, many years ago that I remember seeing when I was a kid growing up. I appear to have let the earth explode into my building. See what I mean by this lag though? Oh, it's a pain. But these characters, the idea is Africa was once united and then it got kind of split in two, and now these two warriors defend the north and defend the south from each other, and that's the edge of the earth is this crack dividing two nations. I don't know, it's all nonsense, but it was fun. And over here, oh no, it's broken. Over here we have what is our first habitat. Now I don't know if they've come inside, but oh, there we go, hello guys. So our giraffe habitat, the indoor portion of it, is part of our initial foyer. I was inspired by a few real-world zoos for this, where one of the animals is present right there in the entrance hallway. People aren't necessarily that thrilled about the situation. But yeah, I thought that was a nice little idea. Moving on then, so we'll wrap around here. We've got a bunch of cool features in here. There's our ticket collection office over there. There is our little dude. We have a couple of shops over here. We've got some bathrooms. We have our ticket offices here as well as our little staff only section over there. And then you enter the zoo itself. That music would naturally play every single time. It would be very obnoxious. So we're going to go to the right first because this is my least favorite habitat. That looks nice though. My least favourite habitat in the entire zoo, that is the warthogs. Now, because we are an Afrikaans zoo, I really wanted to give nods to Afrikaan culture wherever possible, mainly in signs and stuff like that, but there's a few things here. So it means things like warthogs also get their Afrikaans name, which is Vlakvark. Now, Afrikaans is basically a language spoken predominantly in southern Africa. It's actually kind of an amalgamation of Dutch and a few other things. It's very similar to Dutch, but African, essentially. And then we had another idea, and this is over here. So this is the warthogs. Now, this idea didn't get finished, But originally the plan was you would tour the north, you tour the south, and you'd have like a sticker book that you got when you went to the zoo, and you would get a sticker from every single animal. And if you got that sticker from every single animal exhibit, you'd be able to go into the middle of the zoo and enter like this extra final habitat, because you've seen the entire zoo and then you get to see the exhibit in the middle, which is like the uniting exhibit between the north and the south. Obviously that's not how the build went, because we had to end it a little bit early. But the sticker system did stay, so you would get your warthog sticker, and there's our little warthog habitat, innit? People are hating. It's a fairly simple little habitat. The main key feature was this over here, which, you know, isn't much of anything really, but it's like a wood thing. But the warthogs are happy. They've got like a little... You'll notice, anyone who's seen me play this game, frankly, will notice I liked my habitats to resemble what I believe would be like a real world place. So, let's just hop inside, chat. Can I hop inside? No, but we can look above. Warthogs are chilling over there. There's a little baby. I can't get in. There's a little baby, and there's a tent, and there's a campfire, and there's some bunnings hanging from the tree. It's like a little oasis there. So that would be a logical area for someone to camp out. And get more stickers, and there we go. Tusk Bacon. We had a thing where we came up with stupid names for all of our animals. This is all making me want to build a zoo very badly. It doesn't. I need to do smaller zoos, but I kind of want to get back into it. I can't lie. I really do. Anyways, let's go check on our giraffes, otherwise known as Camelopard. Camelopard, and as you see, giraffes over there, and they're all coloured as well. So the left side is, as you see, it's got a lot more water, it's got a lot more grass, the signs are in green, whereas on the right side, the signs are in brown and stuff like that. I did try to keep that theming relatively consistent. So, let's go see our giraffes. You head up here, you head around here. Litter! A teeny tiny little cup for babies. And we can walk around this guy. Can I walk? There we go. So there's our tall horse. Grab your giraffe sticker as we go. And what you can do is you can follow this up here. You can get a little glimpse over there at our hippo habitat. By far the biggest build in this entire park. That was like a 15-hour build or something stupid. And there's our little, you might be able to hear an alarm. The warthog exhibit isn't quite built correctly, so every time the baby walks to the edge, it seems like it's escaped. It hasn't. Although this seems to be a giraffe has escaped. Whatever. There's a little giraffe habitat anyway. I don't know how I'm zooming in with my eyeballs, but I am a very talented person. Hello, beautiful. Would it grow fruit? Is that a human up there? No, it's a plant. Okay. Anyway, so yeah, they've got like a little house over there. We've got a viewing area slash feeding area over here. So the idea was you'd stand here, you get your food from Jordan Eden, you get some watermelon, you get some bananas. Or some Orangenschaften. You'd pick those up from the feeding area, you'd sit here and you'd feed giraffes. It might be that giraffe there that's done a bit of a runner. I might have to fix that. Then again, we're done, so who cares? Yeah, just nice little exhibit. I was kind of still obsessed with domes at this point, so they got a little dome giraffe house. And this also leads down here to where we've got a shaded viewing area, because, well, the shaded area kind of keeps this area shaded inherently, because the sun, you know, whenever it's coming from that direction. But also it means the giraffes can come over and stay nice and cool. I kind of want to double this up, actually, now that I think about it. But it looks very slick, I think. I think it's quite nice. What that tree's doing. There's a staff area over there. And then the path wraps back around. Get another look at the back of the hippo habitat, which you can see has a monorail kind of jazz going on there. So back, this is my little custom fence. It's made of sticks and rope. It's very sexy. Hello. I'm not sure what's going on there. Anyways, right, so that was still part of the sort of the entrance of the zoo. Then you have to enter the zoo proper. Welcome to the Ardesirand. Now, I'm definitely pronouncing that incorrectly. I've gone back and forth on this pronunciation approximately 7.6 billion times, but I'm giving up at this point. It's the final episode, the Ardesirand. Let's just go with it, okay? Earth's Edge, that's what it's called, and there you can see the two guardians of the two sides of the Earth. And as we head forward, you can see, hello, adorable, we have the south over there, so if you turn to the right, you would enter the south. We'll do that in a second, but first we can go to Hippo Harbour, which, as I say, was definitely the more expansive of all of my habitats. So, we go into Hippo Harbour, there we go. We have our, what's our name? It's Seacoy. Seacoy. That's our hippo. Glug, glug, glug. Okay, so this all wraps back around there if you want to. It's just a nice little sort of... terrible. A nice sort of raised walking area. Kind of ties all the pathing together. This is the exit, because as I say... Well, as you'll see in a second. So basically, Hippo Harbour has two different facets to it. One of them is a boat tour, which is what you see right here. And the boat does go all the way around. And it actually goes inside the habitat through there. And you can see sort of the through the glass into the hippo habitat itself. And they sleep in there. So when you go through at night, you can see the hippos sleeping. It's kind of adorable. God knows where the boat is, but the tour does actually function. I think. Hello, buddy. There's our hippo. Always going for a swim. The hell is the boat? And the fact there isn't a boat there means that the boat does function. There's the lass. The lass is actually pregnant. Her name is Moto Moto. She's going to have a baby. There's another part to the hippo tour, however. As you may have seen. Oh, God, I thought that was a real hippo there. I was like, how did he get out there? Excuse me, so this is the monorail entrance, and over there is the boat trip entrance. So, the water blob, if you want to see the water blob, just come over here. You'd hop on the monorail. I'll show you this with the above-ground camera later on. You'd hop on the monorail, and that would take you way up to the top of there. And the hippos can climb all the way up this ridge around here. And there's, like, feeding areas up there and toys area up there, so you can kind of look down and observe your hippos in a fairly chill environment. But, as I say, I'll show you that at the end. Excuse me. Right. Let's head then for the south. So if you want to go north, you keep walking straight. If you want to check out the south, you head to the right-hand side. And all the signs have the Afrikaans and the English and these wonderful fonts made by other people. I did not make the font. The fonts are brilliant. I cannot remember off the top of my head who makes them. I will try to remember to show you at the end of the video, but they've been in the whole series, so you should recognize them by now if you've been watching. There's a little story here. You're now entering the Swede. A harsh and dry climate, yet still beautiful. Sincere. This is just nonsense. Sincere in its simplicity. Take your time on the walking tour, blah, 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 blah. So, the idea behind this was that you're entering an actual village somewhere in South Africa. And I did do research. I looked at South African villages and tried to base the design largely on that. Originally, there's a very large hut here that you were going to enter, but we ended up moving that and changing up the whole shebang. But let's walk forward a little bit. Please stay on the path, of course. And here we go. So this is our little African hut area. We've got like a little campfire here that glows at night. We have our, I don't know what these are, but these totems are, I will say, pretty accurate to what they would look like in real life, albeit still pretty bloody terrifying. I approve. I mean, this would kill several people. Anyways, next up we have aardvarks. I stopped changing the names, so you're going to see some weird names, but if you want to think aardvarks and moist flubber, then go ahead, basically. So this is our aardvark habitat, otherwise known as the aardvark. There you go. So it's mainly a sort of hanging rock formation. You can see through the glass over here, but if you walk a little bit further on, you can just look over into the double-fenced habitat and actually see the aardvarks. Now what you'll notice over there, hello, buddy, is that, you know, there's path up there, there's path up there, there's path around there. And again, this was based on a real African area I saw wherein the houses people were living in were carved into the rock itself. It was like these mounds of rock with holes and pathways, like linking them all together. Kind of like big termite mounds in a lot of ways. Hello? She knows I'm not allowed in here. She's like, get out! Rudiger has malfeasanced. Anyways, I'll show this one in a bit more detail. So this is supporting this. The aardvarks can walk up here, and you see they've got like a little sleeping area up here at the top where they get to look out across the entire habitat. I've done some really nice stuff in this zoo. I kind of forgot. It's been a long time. We've been working on it. Too long. Too long. We'll talk more about the future at the end of the video, but there's our aardvark habitat. Now, next up is the elephant. Elephants. Now, usually the plan was you'd come over here to the right, and this would wrap around, and that's where the turnaround from the jeep tour at the start would be. So that way it looks like people are exiting and entering the zoo. This is one of the parts that never really got finished, and I just don't have time. And like I said, I want to move on to new projects, ones that don't lag so much, and smaller zoos and more intensely decorated but smaller zoos. So we now have like a little under construction area, which I put up around here just to, you know, sometimes zoos do this. They'll have like a shut down area that you're not quite allowed to use yet. So it's not necessarily unrealistic, but it will always be a bit of a shame. Anyways, let's go check out the olifants. So it's this way for aardvarks and the raised elephant viewing. So we again have two ways to feed the elephants, but this is our elephant house. There should be a sign for it. Yes, there it is. Elephant house. And there's our little elephant staggered thing. It's got like a little... I don't know what else to call it. It's a pew pew pew. It's a fountain. It's a squirty thing. It's squirting everywhere. And our little babies on their staggered rocks. I love staggered flat rocks. Mild obsession, just saying. Anyways, elephant house. So you enter in. The back wall never got the love it should have had, but the front, actually there's a pathway up there, we'll go there in a sec. Elephant, collect your sticker, and there is our elephant house. I just wanted something large and grand and very dense in foliage. We went for a long time over the top with the foliage, and I may still have done so, but I ended up being pretty happy with it. The building over there on the right, the African hut over there, was the African hut that was part of the village that we saw earlier. There's a lot of plants in there. I should get rid of those. You see, he's got smoke coming from the roof and everything. I'm a professional. What can I say? Hey guys. Yeah, I just wanted something large and evocative of an area the elephants might live. You know, look like a wild African prairie with those huge ragged rocks in the background and the baobab trees, and the river obviously acts as like a second deterrent to stop them breaking out, because they probably could, but in reality in game they can't get past this little ledge over here, and that river does go all the way into the habitat around there. But I'll show you that in a little bit more detail. There's the big old gates. If we hop around here, hop upstairs on our rocky staircase, lovely stuff. Ooh, there we go. This is our elephant, see, tall horse. our little elephant viewing area. Now, this used to be, honestly, four times the amount of foliage. It was all over the place with this kind of foliage. But people said it was too much, and in reality, it probably was. But I wanted to try something a little bit different. I am trying to pull myself back on the foliage. No, I'm not. I'm Rudiger. I'm visiting the zoo. I know none of the information that I've talked about so far tonight. Okay. Wowee. I bet whoever made this exhibit initially had tons of foliage in here and then got rid of it. There you go. Sorted. just a little raised viewing area. God knows why, but I thought it looked nice. Yeah, elephants. Moving on. This building ended up not disappointing, but I kind of went for this weird L shape. I don't do good with buildings. I really don't. I'm an enclosure design kind of guy. Anyways, that pathway over there just brings you over here. And then this is our next under construction area. So the rest of the south would have been in this direction, but unfortunately, of course, that's not how things really worked out. So we've got a little Planet Zoo sign up. I actually think it looks kind of cool, but yeah, that would be things for another day. Now, we're going to see this enclosure here from two different sides, but the idea was this was a little bit of a uniting of the north and south together a little bit. I think it's animals from the north? Yeah, question mark, yeah. But some environmental aspects of the south. Imagine they live near the border. Anyway, so we go up here under our raised rock tunnels. You'll see I'm obsessed with this, by the way. Just rock with holes in it. It's my jam. I love holy rocks. And over here we have a bridge. Now, you can't see all the details of it from this side. I'll show you those from the other side in a little bit. Would it go well? But over here we have what ended up being a fairly varied little safari, basically. Nothing too complex in reality. There's an ostrich. There's a few different species in here. I can't quite remember what we've got. All I see is a blooming ostrich. If these worked, I'd be able to tell you. But they've all... Well, they're not even broken down. I just don't seem to have ever selected the blooming thing. Oh, there we go. We've got a wildebeest as well. It's a buffalo, mate. I don't know what I'm on about. Ignore me. It's a buffalo. And we have a... If that's Thompson's or a springbok. I think it's a springbok. Thompson's might be in here as well, though. Why do I call it a wildebeest? Anyways, moving on. We'll see those from the other side in a little bit. What's that over there? It's a shadow. Anyways, this area looks really nice from the other side. I'm really happy with this enclosure, but this is basically the end of the south. So, meow, 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 meow. Rudiger puts on his his sneakers for sneaking. He speeds over Nyang, really good. He's a machine. He's a man on a mission. He's going to see the world. He can't do anything to stop him. There's our elephants again. Hello, lovely. I really like that. I mean, that's pretty. I miss this game sometimes. Moving on. So, that's all the stuff. We're going to head back the way we came. We're going to hop back onto the main path, and we're going to follow it to the north. The north. So you walk down a little bit, and as you can see, fairly instantly, it instantly becomes, it's greener, it's lusher, it's wet. It's just how we like it. And this is just like a random little display thing, really. Just a garden of greenness. And we've got some sheltery areas over here. Walk forward a little bit. Lag. And over here, we have the Savannah Safari. Now, if a single person tells me I'm spelling Savannah wrong again, I will... I don't know what I'll do, but I'll throw a cat at you, okay? Savannah, this is how you would spell Savannah in Africa in this situation, okay? Okay? Okay, anyways, I really like this. There's a little jeep because you're going on a safari, of course. And really, this is the kind of... Okay, I'm ready to go. This is the kind of thing the zoo builder likes. Things that are just proppy and themed and all that kind of malarkey, you know? Rudiger's not a big fan, frankly, but we're gonna... big boy. What else we call these? Okay, see that one? Oh, that's my ticket station. Okay, so we must head down here first to the Savannah Safari. And in here we have... It's a Thompson's, not a Springbok, I got it wrong. Common ostrich, Thompson's gazelle, and African buffalo, otherwise known as Volstruis. Eh? Gemsbok. So Thompson's gazelle. Gazelle. As far as I am aware, gazelle in Afrikaans is Gemsbok. So I couldn't find Thompson's gazelle specifically. Maybe it'd be Thompson's Gemsbok. And African buffalo was Buffles. That's without the African, obviously, but the buffalo is Buffles. And then you'd walk forward, and over here we have safari. So basically the safari savannah can be either driven through in the jeep or it can be observed from our observation room here. Now you may notice the design on this is a little bit weird. There's like this weird shape over here. The idea behind this was that it's a tent. I kind of had this vision of, you know, you set up your tent. No, the park maker, whoever that genius was, had this idea of setting up your tent in the middle of the African savannah or whatever. And it's nighttime. And you're looking out into Africa, and it's a tent. So it's all about camping and stuff like that. So that's meant to be the ring pull of a tent, essentially. And that's why it's got this kind of square shape as well. Let's just head inside. This wasn't totally finished, too fruition. And the inside of the tent kind of looks like the outside of the tent. And it's all kind of nonsense. We did originally have lights all over the roof that made to resemble stars, kind of like I did in Black Rock Park, if any of you saw that. Unfortunately, they didn't really work. They lagged out the game massively. And again, it's another problem with just having a very full zoo. But yeah, there's a little campground. And you'd all sit here around the fire and look out into the savannah habitat. You know, through the front of your tent, basically. And into the savannah habitat and observe the animals. Which I thought was kind of adorable, I'm not going to lie. can I pop through that? Yeah. This is a really nice thing I liked as well. I know this wasn't a big deal, but this is the track the jeep takes. And we just put lights on it and we rounded it off with steel and just kind of made it a bit more like an actual part of the enclosure. Kind of raised above the rest of the animals there. I didn't do a bloody thing. I'm Rudiger. I'm here to visit the zoo. Maybe I'm just like a zoo upset. I'm like a zoo fanboy. Hey, get off the path. I just happen to know loads about this zoo. I've become obsessed with it. It's like I'm going to kill the owner in like a vicious attack. It's going to be very strange. Moving on. Exit. Lovely stuff. Up the stairs we go. Stairs around here, which you can see is actually over the entrance path we took. Top level design there. I think you'll all agree. Well done, zoo maker, whoever you are. You handsome devil. And then we're done with this part of the north. Yes, so we head over and we enter the Shattering or something. I can't remember what this was called. And let's stop pretending to be Rudiger for a second. This was one of my more out there ideas. But the idea was that this is the point where the earth has split open between the north and the south, basically. And this whole island, Carnival Island, was carnivores only because those are the animals that the king of the north sent down to protect the north, like, because obviously this is the split. If you imagine this is, you know, Hadrian's Wall or something like that. This is the gap between the countries, so that's where you would protect to protect your country. Same kind of idea, they wanted to protect the north, where the earth is sundered apart, so they sent their carnivores to protect the area. So you walk over the hippo boat enclosure, which one day will have a boat in it. Hello, buddy. Hello, buddy. Oh, he's hustling. He's hustling. He's moving down. He's come down. So this would be the shattering or whatever it's called. And these are, every single one of these rocks is accounted for and wired to something. And then all the lower ones are wired to the... Oh wait, this bit floats, doesn't it? Yeah, that bit floats, god damn it. It's all wired to the ground though. Yeah, so we move forward, there we go, through the shattering. And it's kind of been done so that it looks like it's heavier at the back and then it kind of exploded forward. And this is what we've been working on fairly recently. So walk forward in here, this is... so that's my guy. I had like a vision of, you know, in Dragon Ball Z, where Goku's like, whoa, for like 7 episodes. That's how long it takes. But this guy is the same kind of thing. He's jamming his weapon into the ground, and the rocks are flying up around him, and he's caving the hole into the earth, which is filling up with water. I don't know, we were just doing whatever nonsense we felt like. Staff section there. Vending machines, these are actually quite new to the game. They only came in with the last big update, and this was the first time I got to play around with them. Delicious and nutritious. So over here we have our cheetah habitat. Really nothing too complex, but the focus was on having a really nicely made walkover area, because I'd never really done a walkover before. Wasn't really sure how to do it, so we did some research on that. The enclosure itself is just a fairly typical hello savannah habitat, long grass, blah, blah, blah. But they can walk over here, and as you can see, it's glass underneath, so you can see their little feet. Their little, what do people call them? Toe beans! That's what people call them, because people are obsessed with cats, as they walk across. And again, if you want to see any of this, we've done, you know, plenty of videos on this in the past. But, yeah, you'd see toe beans. And you'd also see the, hello! Adorable. This is their the big sleeping fuming area. This is, of course, one-way glass, as you can see. So from that perspective, it's a pretty chill area to hang out, if a little bit big. But from here, vision. Yeah. Anyways. Then the final habitat we ever built was the hyenas. For this, I wanted the emphasis on... Okay, so hyenas get a bad rap, right? People think of hyenas as kind of spooky and evil, mainly because of the Lion King, but... not only because of the Lion King. That alarm has been going off non-stop. In African, a lot of African cultures, loads of African cultures, hyenas are seen as witches, they're seen as a negative thing, as an evil thing. Like, if your child is born with a hyena nearby, they'll turn into a thief, stuff like that. It ranges and differs from culture to culture. But there is one in particular, oh, I stopped for a second there, that I really liked, wherein a hyena, given their family values, are seen as like a really nice positive thing in the community, and they look after the hyenas and they feed them and stuff like that, because they think that hyenas will drive away wizards or evildoers from their home. So that's kind of what I want to focus on with the hyenas, because hyenas are awesome and they get unnecessarily bad rap. So in the middle, it's just like a little thing. This is when I learned I could use different colours of rock together and it would look cool. That's literally the first time I'd ever done it for some reason. So just a little random area. Again, this was meant to look a bit more like a village. So fencing is fairly simple. Wood strapped onto logs. And if you go around here, you'll see, you know, they've got a wheelbarrow. Hello, buddy. I've said buddy too many times. Got, you know, planks of wood. We've got the wheelbarrow. We've got more of it there. Just some things strewn about. If you imagine, it's kind of the outskirts of a village where the hyenas may be hanging around, because this is where they get fed. You know, there's some construction stuff lying about, but it's not fully built up and civilized. What are you up to? The poop's standing up tall. It looks like fingers reaching up from the earth. It's terrifying. If we walk on a little bit further, though, you'll see there's a little indoor section. Now, this didn't work out how I wanted. I think it looks quite cool. But the idea was that demons are starting to erupt, because hyenas were said to protect from demons and witches, like literally from evil spirits. So the idea was that these demons would start to move up from the crack in the earth generated from this feud between the north and the south. and the hyenas essentially sacrifice themselves by moving into that area to beat back the demons. They themselves had to live in this demon-infested ruins, but, you know, they would protect the people, which is what they were trying to do, because they're cool. That was about it, folks. Like I said, I'll show you it from above. I did add a very quick lion habitat, because it felt stupid not to have a lion habitat. And I mean very quick, it's basically a barrier and a bunch of... There's just nothing special about it at all, it's super, super simple stuff. There's our female lion there, getting nice and moist. The male is... maybe dead? Might have escaped, I didn't check if they could escape this habitat, so there's a good chance this is one of my escapees over here. But yeah, that's really... I just wanted to kind of finish this area off, even if it's not to the standard of everything else. I need to do a better job at keeping an eye on everything. But there you go, there is the full zoo in its total glory. This was not half done, and that's really what was concerning me. So I want to talk very quickly about that. And that was the problem, was that this was not half finished, not even close. And bearing in mind I've added quite a lot since the last videos. It became a lot, it became very heavy, it became humongous, it became laggy. And it was just a little bit too much. I still have dreams of making zoos that accommodate every single animal in Planet Zoo. I haven't given up on that, even though we've not played the game very much lately at all. But what I think I want to do is do much smaller, much more focused zoos. 3, 4, 5 maximum animals, okay? Stuff like that. And that way, when a new DLC comes out, I'll show you the rest of the zoo in a second. When new DLC comes out, say December, January this year, we think we might get a new DLC. You know, we can do like a little zoo focused on that DLC. I would love to do that. I just feel like I can't do that whilst I'm still working on this. So we call this zoo done. Just happy with it. You know, we're going to mark off all the animals on our checklist. All the ones that haven't been in this zoo will get their chance in the future. And we can move on and I can feel a little bit more chill about the whole thing, which is kind of the idea. These are the animals. Whoops-a-daisy. That didn't quite make it. This time really didn't have many from the south at all. North did a little bit better, only missed one actually. North did a lot better for itself, so we can say it's like a north focused zoo, blah blah, but I mean still we had several species in there, all those in as well. And I'm excited for the future. I really don't want to give up on this game. I love this game from the bottom of my heart. I've got 500 hours on it despite not playing it barely for the last 6 months. I really want to do some smaller, intensely focused zoos with just a few habitats. And we can do crazy themes, we can make one, we can have like a pop culture themed one, it doesn't matter, we can do what we want because it's only for, you know, 3 or 4 animals. I like that idea. Hopefully you guys do too. Now, I'll quickly show you the hippo habitat because it is my magnum opus for this exhibit, really. So you can see there's the boat door. Oh, it is there! There you go, so the boat does go all the way around. Actually goes if we zoom up. Goes all the way around Carnival Island. Goes under the bridge there. Comes inside here. It's not a particularly nicely made area, but there you go. You get a little view into where the hippos are hanging out as well. Under the waterfall, around the rock area, and back around into there. There's the hippo habitat. Like I said, it wraps around like that into like a sort of like an S shape up to here. And if you wanted to view that from here, there's a little staircase there, a little walkway, and you can stand over here and look down into the hippo habitat. And then in here we have a bit of a water feature, which is cool. There's lots of water around there and the tree, and it's all pretty and aquatic, which is of course the theme of the area. And this is where you would enter here. We've got like this extra dome over here. You come up here, boop boop boop, hop off here, boop boop boop, walk around here, boop boop boop, and you'd be inside the dome and you'd be able to walk out here and obviously look out over the zoo like that. I mean, no matter how this ended, I know people were disappointed, I've had so many comments about it, I can only apologise that I didn't have the ability to see it through all the way to the end. I am owning up to that, that I over-promised what was possible, I was overly ambitious. But we've made some pretty cool stuff here, we really have, and I'm very proud of some of the work we've done. I really think there's a lot of really cool stuff in the zoo, and I'm excited to hopefully make some more cool stuff going forward. And by me, I mean Rudiger. Rudiger has been so inspired by the zoo, he has decided to make one for himself. Anyways, there's the order, there's all the habitats. I really hope you've enjoyed this video and this series. I know things didn't work out, as I've said, but I still think we built a really cool zoo. Even if things didn't get fully completed to this extravagant amount, we built a really cool zoo. We really did. And it was, you know, you guys were involved from the start. I've been asking for your input and ideas. And a lot of the stuff that happened in this zoo was inspired by you guys at home. So thank you for that. And if we come back with a new zoo, I'm going to want you there on the front lines with me, helping me. And hopefully we can continue to build some pretty cool stuff together. I'm getting all emotional. So, goodbye to the Yadasarund. Who knows what will be next? I think I'm going to hold off just a little bit to see if we get any DLC in December. If we don't, we'll do a mini zoo until the next DLC slash update. I'm assuming it's got a DLC. And if so, then we'll start a new mini zoo in December. And then we'll build an Australian zoo, because I've not built any Australian habitats, which is stupid. And that's what I mean. I'm excited to be able to do that. If we could do small zoos consistently, when a new DLC comes out, I can actually bloody build with it. And that would be really nice. I'd be very excited to do that. Oh, God. Anyways, I hope you all have a lovely day and a lovely week. It's only Monday. You've got a whole week ahead of you. Might be bad for those at work, but just, it's a week of opportunity. Thank you so much for joining me. If you did enjoy the Yada and you want to see more from me, please do let me know in the comments down below. If there's anything you would like to see, because again, you know, this is a collaborative effort. It's how I see this, always have. If there's anything you'd like to see from Planet Zoo in the future on this channel, please do let me know in the comment section down below. No, consistent episodes is not a viable suggestion, because that's always the idea. Leave me alone. Thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks in the next time. In the next time. Why is my keyboard sticky? Thanks for joining me. Cheers, myself, as always. Bye-bye.